Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My beloved children, Eid is around the corner. It's called Eid al-Fitr, which means the day of happiness connected to the breaking of the fast, the ending of Ramadan. So now we are not allowed to fast on the day of Eid. It's haram. You're not allowed to fast on the day of Eid. So why does Allah give us Eid? We fast during Ramadan, we try hard, we obeyed Allah, we stayed away from prohibitions, meaning from what was wrong, we didn't swear, scream, yell, shout, and so on. We stood in prayer, in Taraweeh, or extra prayers. We did ibadah, we gave charities, we reached out to the poor, we tried to do so many good deeds for the whole month. So Allah says, at the end, when you're finished those days, the whole month, from the moon, from the sighting of the moon to the sighting of the next moon. That's a whole month. Sometimes 29 days, sometimes 30 days. At the end, you're not allowed to fast on the day which is the first of Shawwal. So Ramadan is a month in the Islamic calendar. Then you have Shawwal. Shawwal is the next month after Ramadan. The first of Shawwal is always the day of Eid al-Fitr. Haram to fast. You cannot fast on that day no matter what. So if someone asks you, are there any days when it's haram to fast? You say, yes, there are days when it's haram to fast. What are those days? They are Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. The Eid connected to the breaking of the fast after the end of Ramadan. And secondly, the Eid that is connected to the sacrifice of the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. At that time, it's not just one day, but it's that day and another 3 days. Subhanallah. Amazing. Because the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, those days are known as the days of Tashriq. And Tashriq, in the days of Tashriq, you have to eat and drink. You have to eat and drink and remember Allah. That's what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says. So, Eid al-Adha, it's more than one day. And Eid al-Fitr is just one day. Okay. Now, when you've done a lot of good, Allah rewards you. He gives you goodness. He tells you, eat and drink, enjoy, and praise Allah. So what do we say? On that day of Eid, we say, we repeat the greatness of Allah. Tukabbirullaha, which means you must say the takbir. What is the takbir? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallahu, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. You know, some people read it with three Allahu Akbars at the beginning, and some people read it with two Allahu Akbars at the beginning. Both of them are correct. So listen to this one. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. Amazing. I'm sure you'll hear that on the day of Eid. So we're going to prepare for that. We're going to learn that, inshallah. And we're going to read that on the day of Eid. And inshallah, we'll all try and go to where the Eid prayer is being fulfilled. Now, if you have a lockdown or restrictions and you cannot go, then you're excused. Subhanallah. Then you're excused. If you have your own small community, it's better to be in smaller groups where you can actually do the Eid. That's permissible. It's okay. But if you really cannot go out to do your Eid Salah because you're not well or because of restrictions and you're not allowed to go, then it's fine. Allah will not hold it against you. So remember that. But on that day, what should I do? The day of Eid, I should get up early. Don't be lazy. Have a shower or a bath, clean yourself, make sure you have wudu, wear your best clothes. It does not have to be new clothes, okay? But your best clothes. Put a little bit of perfume, inshallah, meaning clean yourself properly, and make sure that you're happy, congratulate each other, greet each other, assalamu alaikum. So the Islamic greeting is what? It's assalamu alaikum. On the day of Eid, it's assalamu alaikum. When Ramadan starts, it's assalamu alaikum. On a Friday, it's assalamu alaikum. The Islamic greeting is always assalamu alaikum. After you say Assalamu alaikum, and the person replies, then you can say Eid Mubarak, you can say Jum'ah Mubarak, you can say Ramadan Mubarak, after you have greeted the Islamic greeting. But don't replace the Islamic greeting with another greeting, whether it's the day of Eid, whether it is the day of Jum'ah, Friday, whether it is Ramadan, don't do that. So what we should do is first use the Islamic greeting that was taught to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the angels, by the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. You say Assalamu alaikum. You can add wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Someone greets you, wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Then you can say sabahul khair, or you can say any other local greeting. Like, you know, you have hello, hi, good morning, how are you? First you say Assalamu alaikum. Then you can use anything else that's probably cultural or whatever else. The same would apply to Eid Mubarak. You don't just meet a person on the day of Eid and say Eid Mubarak, because you're a Muslim. You're supposed to say Assalamu alaikum. So these are some tips. And then on that day, try and phone your friends and family and congratulate them for having fasted in the month of Ramadan, and wish them a happy day, and inshallah everything will go well. You might want to have a meal together depending on the situation in your countries. You might not be able to have a meal altogether, but no problem. You can phone people, you can contact them, you can video call them, your family, your friends, if you cannot get together. Please be responsible, whatever you do, inshallah, and have a lovely, lovely day. It's still coming, but when it does, may Allah bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.